It's March the 26th, 2015. I'm Dana Durnford, also known as nuclearproctologist.org. You can find these videos at beautiful girl boy Dana on YouTube. And we have plutonium 241 from Fukushima. It was 70,000 times. This is another one of these estimates where they're starting to roll out a little bit of the truth. And so what I'm going to do for you is try to put all this into perspective. You got to realize that what you're looking at behind me is based upon a single release from a single reactor. All of these models are not based upon the ongoing release, the actual inventory that was released, constant, endless, hemorrhaging, perpetual motion machine that we're looking at.
Last year, Jackie was a professor in the Department of Nuclear Science and Engineering. She continues to be affiliated with us, and she's a specialist on radiation health effects. The question had to do with what are the prospects for long-term contamination?
Now, unfortunately, we have very little data, almost no data, about how much radiation we can live with at in terms of elevated background levels. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the doses delivered in less than a minute. And so we just don't know how much radiation can be, what kind of contamination level can be considered safe. But as I say, there has not.
All the data is based upon a single minute exposure. And so when you're talking or listening to scientists, this is what they're referring to, a single minute exposure. That raises an interesting question. And what I'm going to show you is what plutonium long-term study does. Meet Dr. Raymond Gilmedy, non-assuming mass murdering of beagle dogs. Dr. Raymond Gilmedy has shown in his studies and through his academics on beagle dogs and beagle puppies. All dogs in a repeated exposure study and all but one dog in a single exposure study died from radiation effects. All dogs, most of them died from lung cancer. 72% of the single exposure and 87% in the repeated exposure died of lung cancer. And the other one had lung cancer that didn't die. Just so you know, Dr. Raymond Gilmedy produced all these studies, 87, 88. He was still doing it on dogs. And as you go all the way through his study, 92, he was also doing it on monkeys, hamsters, and rats. But mostly, every year for sure, he was still using dogs, modeled for the humans. You come down to even 1999, he was still doing it. And studies were conducted in beagle dogs of both genders exposed by inhalation to aerosols of the radionuclides. At MIT, the video I just played for you, they base all their studies upon a single exposure for 1 minute.
To do with what are the prospects for long-term contamination?
Now, unfortunately, we have very little data, almost no data, about how much radiation we can live with at in terms of elevated background levels. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the doses delivered in less than a minute.
But here's all kinds of academic peer-reviewed studies that produced by Loveless Respiratory Research Institute, Dr. Raymond Gilmedy. Now they know who he is because he's been in the media before. So it's not like media doesn't know who Dr. Raymond Gilmedy is. Here's Channel 13.
This is all part of how people think that they're protecting themselves by going off and getting KI, but KI being potassium iodide. Unfortunately, it's probably not going to do them any good.
Why not?
Because here in New Mexico, we're not going to get exposed to any radioiodine.
Dr. Gilmay has researched radioactive respiratory health for 4 decades in New Mexico.
Had them up there, but yet they don't refer to his studies on the beagle dogs. They refer to a single exposure.
All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the doses delivered in less than a minute.
So it's a betrayal. You're looking at a betrayal in many ways, not only to the animals, of course, but a betrayal to the actual study, because he's got 35 years killing beagle dogs.
Dr. Gilmay has researched radioactive respiratory health for 4 decades in New Mexico.
And beagle puppies, and it's not like he doesn't know what he's talking about, so how come they don't use that when they're talking about plutonium? Why do they only talk about the single exposure where nobody died? And so this showed the animals died. Of course, the animal dies, then we're going to be the same way.
All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the dose is delivered in less than a minute.
I'll be in the Queen Charlotte's for another few days, so I'm at the hotel again, and that was compliments of Elaine, and we are extremely grateful because it's been a very difficult trip, and now is the time to definitely have a little break. And the idea of doing this through the winter, by the way, is because it has to get done. We have to do this job. And the longer it takes to get started, the longer it takes to actually finish the project, and the longer it'll take again to get that data out where we can have a debate about it. And because we went through the winter, and I agree, it's not the best time of the year to go do anything, but when you talk about a Pacific Ocean that is devastated, you have to realize what the urgency really truly is. Now, I was talking to a man on the wharf today who asked me, did I realize the phytoplankton and the phosphorus and the krill were missing, and that the ocean right here where we were to this morning should be full of that stuff, and he was shocked. It was a very interesting conversation. Unfortunately, he didn't want to go on video. Plutonium-241 from Fukushima was nearly 70,000 times more than what the atomic bomb fallout in Japan. But what a reactor is doing, it's completely different than what a nuclear bomb does. It blows up, and about 5% of the fissionable product is atomized and aerosoled. The nuclear reactors, and if you're not familiar with that, I better whip up a little picture here, I guess, to get you back up to speed. Japan had a massive, unbelievable earthquake. It was over 9 magnitude. Each magnitude is 100 fold. It's not like you're on a scale of 1 to 10. It's a 9. 7 to 8 is a huge, massive difference. How long it lasts, how much energy it has, how far and damage it creates. So when you get up into the 7s and the 8s, these are massive numbers. When you get to 9, it's destructive beyond imagination. And Japan suffered that. It threw a tsunami that wiped out around 500 kilometers of the coastline and the infrastructure and annihilated everything in its path. Tore up all the infrastructures, the roads, the telephone poles, the light and power, and the resources were used to go save friends and families and people in distress for many, many weeks after and before it even started to slow down. And then you had all the refugees and the people displaced in that country. While all this was going on and people were exposed to the elements because their homes were destroyed, this tsunami had went in and destroyed 4 reactors at Japan. Now, all the models that you see are based upon this unit here. This is Unit 1 at Fukushima. And they only based the models, the air and the ocean dispersal models from major institutions around this planet, upon this one unit for just a couple of days worth of releases. Never based it upon a full meltdown. Never based it upon the fuel pools that were atomized and aerosoled and lost your fuel pools, are where you take the reactor cores, 5 million pounds, and bring it up on the roof and you put it in the fuel pool. There is no roof there anymore. That's where the fuel pools were up here. This is Unit 2, and now they admit the fuel is gone out of that and you don't know where it's to. This is very grave. It was just a single reactor on the planet. But none of this stuff is in the models, the ongoing constant releases. And so the melted cores are constantly chewing up everything around it and radiating them, ionizing, radiating rocks, the atoms of rocks, the atoms of a pencil, the atoms of the rebar and the cement that falls down on top of it. The rocks that is cannibalizing, the material cannibalizing, is made of atoms. And they're just as deadly once the chain reaction came in contact with them. All the water you're spraying on it is atomized and aerosoled in the sulfur peroxide buckyballs from the first 40 days of using salt water really changed the game and made this extremely, extremely pertinent and dangerous. They tell you about Unit 1, they show you models, but they don't bother showing you models from Unit 3. And the whole inventory is lost, completely 100% gone. That's 3 100% meltdowns. Chernobyl was only 1/3 the size of any of these reactors. Chernobyl was a 30% meltdown. These are 100%. Chernobyl only lasted 10 days. These things have been going on for 4 years, over 1,460 days, with no end in sight. Once again, Chernobyl, 10 days, 12 at most. These things are 100% meltdowns. And the MOX fuel that they use in this reactor is millions of times worse than any other reactor on the planet. By proxy, this one unit alone is around, because it's 3 times the size and 100% meltdown versus Chernobyl, 30% and a 1/3 meltdown, it's 18 million times worse than Chernobyl, 18 million times. This is because they used what's known as a mixed oxide fuel, MOX fuel. So you took missiles from the Cold War, nuclear missiles have been sitting and are already unstable and have all kinds of issues, and you put it through a chain reaction again. That was what was up on the roof. The plutonium was in all the reactors. And so Unit 4 just to make sure you're up to speed. It lost its inventory. Now, the fuel pools, when they lose their zirconium cladding because they catch fire or they're exposed to air, they'll catch fire. There's usually this very sophisticated hard water they use to contain the neutrons. And it's not containing it, it's just slowing it down from killing everybody in the plant. The fuel pools will normally boil off 120,000 liters into your community every day. And remember, these buildings detonated, so they threw the fuel rods and the pellets all over the site. And so the rod pellets themselves, the fuel themselves, are splitting atoms and releasing X-rays and neutrons. And that's why you only see the homeless in that Fukushima. You don't see Harvard or Yale or Stanford or MIT or Oxford or any of the major institutions on the planet sending in nuclear scientists. And, you know, the only nuclear scientist we hear from is Arne Gunnarsson. All other nuclear scientists are not allowed to talk about this. And that's a betrayal, another betrayal. Because how else are people going to be able to get a handle on what's going on if the nuclear scientists are going to allow the nuclear PR firms to do all the speaking? Do they really think they're going to have a pension? I can't imagine how. In 1987, Dr. Raymond Gilmedi was still going strong over a decade later, killing beagle dogs and beagle puppies with the smallest particle imaginable. Yet all the models out there are not based upon what he was doing, his studies, his academics, the thousands of other institutions that were killing mammals. They're all based upon a single-minute release. And that's the MIT, just after Fukushima, had told you that.
We have very little data, almost no data, about how much radiation we can live with. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation in which all the doses delivered in less than a minute. And so
The data that you're allowed to use is based upon that, but the data is already out there about what this stuff does. You were not willing to go down that road. You were only willing to go down the road you were told to go down, Jacqueline Yates from MIT. See, that's the betrayal, the complete and utter betrayal of academics on this planet. They knew these studies, and these studies went all the way up into the 2000s, killing mammals and animals, and thousands of institutions doing that, yet they can't talk about it. All they can tell you about is...
We have very little data, almost no data, about how much radiation we can live with. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation in which all the doses delivered in less than a minute. And so
it's just a total betrayal. And that's why you have to learn this stuff. That's why you have to know this stuff. That's why I make these videos, because you have been lied and manipulated and deceived for decades, and it's time for the truth. We don't have time to play games anymore. They lied to us and put us in this predicament. Japan is not testing for plutonium and highly radioactive water. And the Japanese media has blacked out the words MOX, plutonium, and meltdown. Fox News, all of the stricken reactors and spent fuel pools contain plutonium. New York Times, July 12, 2012, radioactive material like cesium and plutonium, uranium and americium and iodines and everything else are brought back to 129 with a 50 million year half-life iodine are brought back to the surface soil each year by plant growth and pollination. March 24, neutrons are emitted during chain reaction. A nuclear chain reaction is feared at spent fuel pools. Neutron beams seen 13 times at Fukushima may be evidence of nuclear fission or release of plutonium. Neutron beams suggest uranium and plutonium have leaked and nuclear fission has occurred. England's Sellafield was closed because of Fukushima. 50% of that fuel was for TEPCO. The toxicity of plutonium not very different than salt. Now, that's not what Dr. Raymond Gilmedi showed us on the beagle dogs and beagle puppies. Dr. Raymond Gilmedi knew that in 1979 that plutonium was going to kill the animals. And so he flushed that out way back then. But yet all the doses are based upon a...
About how much radiation we can live with. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation in which all the doses delivered in less than a minute. And so...
So less than a minute. Yet Dr. Raymond Gilmedi, since 1974, produced study after study after study on the beagle dogs and puppies that the smallest elements from the chain reaction would kill the animals. So there's your lying. You know, it's disgusting. Plutonium evaporates and spreads around as gas, 120 billion becquerels. they're alluding to how much came out in the first 100 hours. This is much more than Chernobyl. Japan's catastrophe is already more serious than Chernobyl. Radiation around Fukushima near levels where humans vomit uncontrollably and hair could be stripped from the body. March the 14th, 3 days after. Chernobyl resulted in 1 million deaths worldwide. What they're saying here is 500% more cancer fatalities when using MOX. MOX is 2 million times worse. And so it's 2 million times whatever Chernobyl was. So mammals and animals, including birds and the marine life. Black smoke billows from number 3 containing plutonium. Once again, Fox says they all had plutonium in it. Neutron source, see, these are so important, found 1 mile from Fukushima. Nuclear journal on Fukushima plutonium effects. Melting MOX fuel may lead to neutron flux blow-up. Surprisingly, there's absolutely no reference data in any scientific literature. It's the same thing with Dr. Raymond Gilmedy. They use, when they're talking to the population, they say everything's based up on a 1 minute dose. Not that they mention that very often. But yet Dr. Raymond Gilmedy got 40 years. You know, he's the expert, right? He showed us that plutonium will kill all the creatures. Fukushima released 13 billion times more neutrons than initially estimated. It was a huge number initially estimated, a massive number, and it's 13 billion times that. Fukushima melted reactor core still active from releasing neutrons many months after 3/11. They were still hemorrhaging into the environment. This was February 19, 2015, they reported on it. Official in Fukushima, please, please help us. Hot particles of melted fuel are inhaled by children every day. Please let the people in the world know the life we are living. Nuclear chain reaction may have lasted over 7 months at Fukushima. It didn't stop. The reactors all melted down, as I showed you earlier. MOX fuel could be a neutron source. All of the reactors had plutonium in them. They're all MOX fuel. University of California Dean, we detected far more than I expected of Fukushima's radioactive sulfur after 3/11. Up to 1,500 atoms in a cubic meter of air. So if you're walking through California, you could expect to breathe in just massive amounts every day. And so like the dog study shows, this stuff is going to catch up to you. Like the book Orwell, 1984, Dr. Raymond Gilmedy was producing study after study of killing animals, rats, hamsters, dogs. And the particle size didn't matter. It was going to give the animals cancer. Yet all the studies, I mean, these studies have shown you the diffusion and the way that it gets into the bones and the lungs and the damage. But the models were not based up on that. No, why tell you about that? They told you about a 1 minute study, a single exposure. And for the next 50 years, that's all they used when they were talking about it. Nobody bothered mention what happened to the dogs, the hamsters, the rats. No, they only told you about this.
Very little data, almost no data about how much radiation we can live with. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the doses delivered in less than a minute. And so,
but it's not like they never had access to these studies, is it? It's not like they didn't know these existed, did they? All the way back to 74, 10 years later, still killing the dogs, but no mention of it. Media doesn't even bother it. You know, it's just a despicable society. The media knew about that, see? That's the problem. They knew about this. It doesn't drop you usually right in your tracks. It has been known to do that. But what's going to happen is in the next couple of years, you're really going to see the damage show up. We're already seeing it in the Pacific Ocean right now. I'm on the Expedition for Life in the hotel room in the Queen Charlotte's Hideaway doing that coastline, and it's devastated. Plutonium could be causing fissions, heating up the melted fuel, and all the reactors had this in them. Melting MOX fuel may lead to neutron flux blow-up. Nuclear explosion may have occurred at Fukushima's Unit 3 after supercritical condition. Sudden increase in plutonium uranium recorded by U.S. at several EPA stations. Yet, when they have Senate hearings, they say there was absolutely no record of that showing up here. But there's endless records of it showing up in America and Canada, North America, anywhere, everywhere.
The NRC has held more than 150 public meetings to get input on our Fukushima work and share progress. The NRC receives regular reports on the status of the Fukushima site from the government of Japan and the Tokyo Electric Power Company as they continue their work at the damaged reactor buildings.
Because the cost of Fukushima, might I remind you, is pretty much immeasurable, and the benefits of avoiding that is pretty much immeasurable.
Tell me what I'm overlooking here. Well, on the face of it, I must agree, it doesn't look good.
Okay, that's a good response. How about you, Mr. Madwood?
Yeah, this senator, I think that...
Maybe it winds up in court. Maybe we sue you. I don't know what we do.
Mr. Madwood?
Because the cost of Fukushima, might I remind you, is pretty much immeasurable, and the benefits of avoiding that is pretty much immeasurable.
We're also closely coordinating with other U.S. federal and state agencies regarding information about current concentrations of radioactive contamination in the Pacific Ocean. Based on the best scientific information available, no agency in the United States or abroad has identified any evidence of concerns for U.S. food and water supply or public health.
And I need to know what whistleblowers are saying. I need to know that all, because I swear that I will uphold this Constitution and defend and protect the people that I represent and the people of this country. So this is not a good relationship, and it certainly isn't.
Well, on the face of it, I must agree, it doesn't look good.
Okay, that's a good response. How about you, Mr. Madwood?
Senator, I think...
The situation may be worse than thought, as studies from last year indicate that radioactive water will contaminate the entire Pacific Ocean in just 6 years. Kim Minji reports.
This graphic shows the gradual contamination of the Pacific Ocean due to leaks of radioactive water from the crippled Fukushima nuclear plant in Japan. The simulation, which was run by a German marine research institute, shows the entire Pacific water is being polluted by radioactive water in just 6 years.
On BBC, a professor warns underground ice wall could become neutron reflectors and cause a nuclear chain reaction, yet they're still going ahead with the ice wall. Experts to try and determine how much plutonium is in the Fukushima melted nuclear fuel. Try and determine. They know what's there. They know the reactors were using melted missiles. I call them melted, but reprocessed missiles that were already unstable after 50 years from the Cold War, nuclear missiles, and then put through the chain reaction. That's why we have the issues we got. Private testing finds high concentration of plutonium in soil over 30 miles from Fukushima. Very high radiation that is very different to what the government released. Curium-244 detected for the first time at Fukushima plant. Requires a lead shield 20 times thicker than plutonium-238 to protect yourself, and has a 500 times greater fluence of neutrons. 400 billion neutrons released per square meter surface of spent fuel pool between March 13th and the 20th. 400 billion neutrons released per square meter. That's the size of your dinner table. Reactors could break like glass during accident. Neutrons change the properties of steel and become fragile. So the reactor is very unstable. A ton of plutonium was in each Fukushima reactor. This is Gunderson. A ton of plutonium, listen to these words I'm talking about. A ton of plutonium was in each and every Fukushima reactor, not just Unit 3, see? Neutron rays were measured in Tokyo. Uranium-235 was found in Chiba, and it can't be detected by a typical Geiger counter. You need a very sophisticated one. You need to be trained to use it properly, and you need to calibrate for those isotopes. Plutonium-238 from inside reactors went far from Fukushima explosion. Misleading media said it would stay close by. Oh, it's heavy. It's going to fall to the ground right away. This is what they told you over and over, and they do that even now in the comment sections. It's very disgusting what the nuclear PR firms do. They're absolutely maniacal people.
Currently in Japan, in the water right off the beach at Fukushima, if you stayed in the water for the whole day, you would receive on the order of 10 nanosieverts in the course of the day. In other words, about 0.3% of the normal daily dose that everyone gets.
The most disgusting part of our society is a nuclear PR firm. TEPCO, either neutrons cause a chain reaction or criticality due to increased water injection. So when they were spraying all that salt water on it, what salt water is going to do to the machinery is going to destroy it. Fuel pellets could have been carried to different parts of the plant. No, the plants detonated. The explosions were felt 25 miles away. The fuel rods were blown 5 miles up in the air.
A new computer simulation shows how radioactivity spread around the world from the disabled Fukushima Daiichi plant. The simulation was created by a group of researchers at the University of Tokyo and Kyushu University and released on Wednesday. The simulation is based on the scenario in which Contaminated air was vented from the disabled number 2 reactor building on March 14th, 3 days after the massive earthquake and tsunami. Computer images show the radioactive material was lifted 5,000 meters into the air. It was then carried by westerly winds and spread over the Pacific Ocean. The images indicate that on the fourth day after the being vented, the substances reached the west coast of the United States, and on the seventh day, they approached Iceland after crossing the Atlantic.
Surely could have been carried to the other parts of the plant and that entire community. Because something that goes up 5 miles can travel a long distance before it hits the ground, if there's any wind at all, and there was. And TEPCO won't deny that the fuel may have burrowed into the ground. They plowed it into the ground with remote control bulldozers so that Fukushima 50 could originally get in there. So everything that landed on the ground, that's what they done. They went in and they just plowed it under the soil and it sank down into that topsoil, and that's why they had to perpetually put water on that site, because that's splitting the atoms and releasing X-rays and neutrons. Now, New York Times headlines, I had to put this one there, spent nuclear fuel really waste. They should get Matthew Wald, right, who just got a promotion to work for a nuclear industry, and you should stuff him full of nuclear rods until he dies. A pound of it will kill everybody in a club in 20 minutes. It'll kill everybody till the end of time every 20 minutes. That's the problem with this stuff. It's maniacal. Japanese ex-industry minister, neutron radiation is degenerating reactors, admits he was playing a role when saying nuclear plants were safe. Because they knew that the neutrons coming out of the rods, and they have it in hard water, it destroys all the material around it. It destroys the metal and the cement, the integrity of everything. That's the problem with this stuff. Deplorable plutonium detected at 5 locations. Unknown which reactor plutonium came from. It came from them all. Came from a mall, and they want you to believe there's only one deer with plutonium into it. 3 different types of plutonium detected around Fukushima nuclear plant. CBS says toxic plutonium pools discovered at Fukushima. Toxic plutonium pools. That's an understatement. More plutonium found in Fukushima Daiichi soil detected in 4 samples. Uranium 238 was detected in Hawaii, Southern California, and Seattle. Melted fuel in reactor number 3 appeared to have burned through the pressure vessel, loaded with rods containing plutonium.
So why are the Japanese so worried about Reactor 3? One strong possibility is that Reactor 3, unlike the other reactors, has what is known as a mixed oxide fuel, which has reclaimed plutonium in it, in addition to uranium. And nuclear engineers in the West have said that if that plutonium is dispersed through fires or explosions, that would produce an even more hazardous radioactive plume than the dispersal of the uranium fuel rods found in the other 5 reactors at the site. Unfortunately, the Japanese have already indicated that the helicopter drops on Reactor 3 do not appear to have been successful. There was quite a bit of wind blowing, and so as a result, the latest effort is to try to use water cannon to try to get water into Reactor 3. Water cannons are usually used by police to try to disperse rioters. So what the Japanese authorities are really trying to do here is improvise, try to find new solutions to new problems that keep coming up every day.
Most of the fallout from plutonium-containing MOX fuel will drop on the U.S. unless very strong winds take it elsewhere. Dr. Raymond Gilmedi had showed that the smallest amount of plutonium or americium would kill a dog, and he'd done these studies over and over and over to the point where how could you deny and claim that all the experiments and all the studies are based up on a single minute.
We have very little data, almost no data, about how much radiation we can live with. All of our data come about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the doses delivered in less than a minute. And so we...
So all the doses that they use are based up on a minute, but Dr. Raymond Gilmedi, they don't use that. How come? There's thousands of Dr. Raymond Gilmedis out there killing animals. They don't use those studies. How come? Why don't they tell you that? It's a question you need to ask yourself and realize that I'm not the bad person. That guy is. If it goes up into the jet stream, just a single plume, it takes 10 years to rain out. It hasn't stopped going up to her. It's never going to stop going up to her because we won't try to stop. We won't even have a debate about it. We ignore it like it's not happening, and it will get every one of us at some point. Right now, it's wiping out the Pacific Ocean. Two explosions may have occurred early on at reactor number 3, very similar to Chernobyl. Likely at least several hundred pounds of plutonium was ejected. The building was completely demolished by these explosions. There was nothing left inside of it. If it didn't atomize an aerosol, it was blown out several miles away, all over the site. That's why they only sent in the homeless. Possibility of radiation from the MOX fuel in the reactor, a combination of uranium and plutonium, could be released. Possibility! The building's detonated. The buildings have 100% meltdown, but the media can't tell you the truth. They just can't do it. If they'd done it, I think everybody there would die of a heart attack immediately because they told the truth. That's not what they got the job to do. They got the job to do to cover up what's happening. That's why they got the job at the media, in television, in your radio. Their job is to cover it up.
My name is Martin Fackler. I am the Tokyo Bureau Chief for the New York Times. And the question of what do you tell your public?
There are strict rules about what we can and can't film.
You know, I mean, do you tell them that there's a serious nuclear accident?
The opposite. And
you know, I mean, do you tell them that there's a serious nuclear accident, or do you play it down?
March 24, BBC, neutrons are emitted during chain reaction. And a nuclear chain reaction was feared at the spent fuel pool. So it's not just a reactor that can go into a chain reaction. The spent fuel pools up on the roof can go into a chain reaction all on their own. And they're no different than a melted reactor. That's the problem. And all of these buildings had fuel pools on the roof of it, and they all caught fire and detonated and aerosol and atomized. NHK confirmed 10 million times unusual levels in reactor number 2. Reactor number 2, when you look at it, the building is still intact. 10 million times the usual levels. That's dead man walking stuff. That's why, like I said, they got the homeless only there. Fukushima melted reactor core still active and releasing neutrons many months after 311. And the radioactive sulfur was the highest ever measured in any atmospheric sample. Now, atmospheric sample is not in your garden. That's up in the sky. And so that circulates the planet till the end of time, literally, being re-liberated. Very serious possibility that the pools of molten fuel in the reactor could restart a nuclear chain reaction. Very high concentration of hot particles in the Pacific Northwest during April and May includes plutonium and americium. And americium, what Dr. Raymond Gilmedy was also using on beagle dogs and beagle puppies. Dr. Raymond Gilmedy was aware in 1974 of how deadly americium was. He'd done the experiments on baboons back then, and he showed that the americium produced leukemias in the skeletons of the adult baboons. So it was very tiny, tiny amounts, but all the models are not based upon what Dr. Raymond Gilmedy was doing. No, why do that? They're based upon a single exposure for 1 minute instead of Dr. Raymond Gilmedy's 84 academic studies.
We have very little data, almost no data, about how much radiation we can live with. All of our data about the health effects of radiation come from a situation which all the doses delivered in less than a minute.
It is so critical now, local Japanese officials send an SOS concerning plutonium, strontium, and other radionuclides. It's over 2,000 of them. Please let your neighbors and friends to know the situation and ask for help. 50,000 becquerels a kilogram of radioactive cesium found in soil near Tokyo. Terrifying, the samples were from the side of the street where children walk every day. Remember, every fine cesium, there's 100 times more strontium-90. NRC now says reactors and containments have breached and released plutonium off-site. Much worse than if from spent fuel pools right from the containment. 76 trillion becquerels of plutonium. So every second it's releasing 76 trillion becquerels. And then they find more, that's another 76 trillion becquerels, 152 trillion becquerels, and then another 152 trillion becquerels here. So every second, these numbers are adding on to it, and there's more per second being released. And so as it's hemorrhaging into the ocean, yesterday is still going to be releasing whatever released originally till the end of time. Corresponding Neptunium 239 flew at least 60 kilometers from the Fukushima meltdown. Government emits plutonium 238 detecting locations far, far from Fukushima plant. In North America, in Canada, in the United States. Dave, you know, like I just showed you earlier. Wall Street Journal, a potential disturbing term, plutonium discovered far from the Fukushima reactors. All I'm trying to do is show you all the headlines that actually exist. Wall Street Journal. New Scientist, plutonium from Fukushima was expected to rapidly disperse in the Pacific Ocean. Instead, it seems that the levels remain high because it's constantly coming out. It's not going to stop. It's gone into these chain reactions, and there's multiple melted reactors. We've never seen a 100% meltdown on this planet. We have no data on that we know about, they admit to. And we have three 100% meltdowns in Fukushima. If that's not an emergency, why was it such a big issue over Chernobyl? They couldn't eat the meat in Ireland, Scotland, and Britain for the next 20-odd years. But yet they're far, far removed from Ukraine. But yet they're saying that three melted reactors, the jet streams come straight to North America, Canada, and the United States. No big deal. Don't worry about it. Go back to sleep. Not intending to go back to sleep. Government, plutonium doses at 27 microsieverts. Is that some kind of joke and will remain for about 50 years? See, two lies in a row. By the way, microsieverts is what you're looking for medical and hospitals. That's not what you look for from nuclear. It's designed to deceive you, manipulate you, misrepresent what really truly is the issue. Japanese Times, it is now a grave situation at Fukushima.
And on waste, it's piling up, and we need a final solution for that, preferably by centralizing the waste, not by having tens of thousands of small waste dumps around Fukushima Prefecture. Thank you.
Plutonium fission mentioned for the first time. Criticality is very likely to have occurred. Gee, you don't suppose the problem is that that's all you do is lie.
See the heart of the decommissioning work taking place here in Reactor 4.
At the end of our tour, we were checked for radiation exposure. In 4 hours, I received the equivalent of less than a chest x-ray.
And so we can't have a debate with anybody about anything because everybody's filled up with the nonsense from all the lies. Krypton 85 up over 14,000% in one day at reactor number 2. And it's used to detect plutonium separation. TEPCO blames spontaneous natural nuclear fission for radioactive xenon. What about the 14,000% increase in the Krypton 85? This was TEPCO trying to hide away what was really happening. Belgium agrees to end the nuclear power October 31st, 2011, because they got it. Cesium-137 levels in the well water, 6,500 times normal. Plutonium detected in 10% of the samples. You got any idea how crazy this is? How just absolutely disgusting that we can't trust a single scientist on the planet anymore? How depressing that really is. Plutonium will no longer be measured, Japanese government. Almost impossible for a normal person to detect. And Geiger counters are ineffective. TEPCO preparing to dump decontaminated water in the ocean still has strontium after decontamination, likely plutonium, uranium too. Look, if they were able to solve these problems, we wouldn't have the problem at Chernobyl. We wouldn't have problems with nuclear plants at all. You can't do that. So all you can do is lie. And then the media comes out and tells you to lie over and over and over, and you can't have a conversation. And that's why all these people should hang right in your streets. Researchers discuss hot particles of americium found in Tokyo, and it comes from plutonium. Americium-241 and plutonium detected in all soil samples off the Fukushima coast. And TEPCO says, not caused by a meltdown. TEPCO won't be saying much in the future because they're going to have to all hang at some point. Why do media repeat what TEPCO says when all they do is lie? Because that's all media does is lie. So that's the game. All three Fukushima reactors had enormous amounts of plutonium inside before melting down. All three Fukushima reactors were MOX fuel. All three of them. Over and over and over, I can show you this stuff. Plutonium and uranium in reactor number 3 has all been blown out. This was no ordinary explosion. All of the western U.S., most of East Coast, Midwest, Canada, covered, buried with airborne particles at various altitudes on March the 20th. Fukushima plume model shows based solely on the reactor number 1 explosion. It doesn't include the ongoing, constant, never-ending, perpetual murder machine releases that it is, or the other reactors. And it's a frightening model. Aerosol plutonium from Fukushima detected in Europe. Japanese government did not reveal plutonium-241 detection. The radiation dose was 50 times higher than the total of all other three plutonium isotopes that were mentioned. Radioactive sea spray has been shown to blow hundreds of kilometers inland. And so that's why you have to move away from the Pacific coastline. You have to, because it's not going to stop going into the ocean. The currents come straight across to North America in 45 days. Not a couple of years, not 10 years, but 45 days. And behind it is 44 more plumes because it doesn't stop hammering into the ocean. And so when one plume hits you here after 45 days, it's a perpetual motion machine. They found plutonium in every sample. Radiation absorbing bacterium is everywhere on paved surfaces. The slower you spread radiation dose, the more effective it produces cancer. Japan is going the very best way in the world. They're destroying the entire human race and every other species on this planet. We'll be heading back out on the ocean in a couple of days. And once again, you know, we got to get the job done, whether it was winter or whenever. We put the operation together, get the data, and then we can push back. Hugs for everybody.
As you get lower and lower, there are still effects. And as we saw from the pictures, that even a single hot particle, if consumed or inhaled into the body, can produce a cancer.